let's get ready for Don Cherry's Rock'em Sock'em Hockey. Get ready, folks, for the next little while. We're going to show you what I call Rock'em Sock'em Hockey. We're going to start with the goaltenders. Now, why would anybody want to be a goaltender? Blue likes them, but she's a little flaky, too. Jerry Cheever's the flakiest guy of them all. No, I'm just kidding, Jerry. I remember one time in Philadelphia, it was unbelievable. Billy Barber cut around the outside, let a shot go you couldn't believe, hit Jerry right between the eyes, blood's coming all over Blue, you can't believe. I go out, there's my meal ticket. I can't believe it. There's my meal ticket lying there. I go out, I pull the mask off, blood's coming from everywhere. I say, Jerry, Jerry, speak to me. You okay? He looks up at me with one eye and he says, I'm okay. Grapes, how's the crowd taking it? Okay, let's take a look at the goalies. Now we're going to show you why you have to be a little flaky to be a goalie. Watch Scrudlin send Gosselin flying. Donnelly nails Hayward. Anderson falls over Rudy. Buffalo's tough guy Kevin McGuire drills Stefan. And folks, this is what happens when you hit a winged goalie. Where's Kevin's teammate? He's all alone. Probert lays out Keynes. Well, I thought there was an unwritten rule not to run the goalies. Well, I guess these guys never read it. Nylund fouls Vernon and the post. Then Beesbrook makes a nice save and the Flames pile on. Gould crunches Gosselin. There are two ways to score a goal. You can beat the goalie with a nice shot, or you can drive him into the net like these guys. Ferraro puts Hayward and the puck into the net. Capri stops the puck and Graham. Or Poopa gets crunched by McPhee and his own teammate. Now watch this. Dale Hunter falls on Gosselin. He can't get up because his skate lace is caught up in Gosselin's pants. Look at him kicking away there. Kicks him in the face. I don't think Dale wanted to get up too much. Look at him appeal the referee. I can't get up. I can't get up. Watch. Folks, sometimes a player gets at an angle where he can't score. So he does what we call a waster. Watch Cortino pull a waster to straighten up Peg of Chicago. Peg's got a lot of heart. He finished the game. The legend of Al McKenna's fierce slap shot was born on this play. Or Brian Hayward stops the puck with his head, but the Leafs score anyhow. Now watch Devils McLean KO Peters on this shot. Peters okay, he played the next game, I think. In Colorado, I had the worst goalie in the world, Hardy Astrom. And this is what I call a Hardy special, letting it in from the red line. Tough one, Darren. If Steve Weeks lets it go, it goes right over the net. Tough luck, Stevie. Another thing, Hardy was bad at handling the puck, and even the best make mistakes. Ronnie Hextall gets a nice assist on McAway's goal. Alan Bester fires the puck around the boards, and Dougie Gelmar puts it home. But in hockey, all things equal out, and Gosselin sets up the goal for the Leafs. Goalies are supposed to be good skaters, but with all that equipment, sometimes it looks like they need double runners. Here's Pete Peters making a bid for the bench. You know, Pete may be able to stop pucks, but I don't think he'll make the ice skate. Mike Liu, look out for the goalpost. Don't hurt yourself, Mike. Here's Calgary's great little goalie, Mike Vernon. Hey, Mikey, I know Pittsburgh's not that great, but I don't think you should give them the whole net. Folks, the goalies sometimes think the rink is against them. Watch this. Peter Savoda does a bank job on Bobby Nation. Winnipeg Steve Yellen says, I can do that, and he doesn't. Folks, you ever notice it's the home team putting them in here? They know the boards. Watch Bork bouncing in on the friendly Boston boards for my buddy Cam Neely. Folks, we've been making fun of the goalies. Now watch them shine. Vernon Rob Svoboda. Chevrier stones the Habs twice. Pure douses the Flames. Hayward, nice save on the Devils. Kylian Messier. Cloutier sends Gainey into retirement. Hayward stops Nieuwendyk and sends Lou back to Finland. Hooray! Bester robs Woods. Gosselin blanks Anderson. Nice save. How many times have you seen this? Goalie makes a big save and the other team comes right back to score. Slides it home. McLean on Poulin. Gosselin, nice save on Gartner. Lemelin robs Bobby Smith. Waugh picks it out of midair, and Chelios tries for a home run. Duchesne thwarted by Fuhr. Gosselin steals one from Richet. Two beauty saves by Pokey. Bester betters Gilmore. Patrick Waugh stands his grounds against Philly. A great save by Brent Fuhr. Hayward stops Mario the Magnificent. Fuhr proves you can't do it all by yourself. Six stops on the Bruin, but Bork finally puts it home. Watch. Out to Bork, watch this shot. Top four, what a beauty. Waugh denies McDermott. Beauty save by Bernetta. Moog steals one from the Oilers. Pokey stops the 70-goal man, Nichols. Tugnut stops Ferrero. Burke gives a bad rebound, but comes up big on the Leafs. Tugnut again on Babich. Bester performs heroics against Vancouver. Fuhr upset and still comes up with a big save. What a goalie. McLean stops Mullen. Not too many guys did this year, though. Waugh stops the most underrated guy in the league, Colin Patterson.
You know, hockey is a game of mistakes. You know, even the best of guys make mistakes. Bobby Orr, the great Bobby Orr, even had hands of stone sometime. I remember in the Boston Gardens one time, he put the puck in his own net. You know what I mean? We really felt bad. It was embarrassing. Bobby Orr, he's skating over to the bench, you know, and some guy hollers down, "Hey, Orr, that goalie should have had it." So if Orr can do it, anybody can do it. Now, we're not making fun of these guys. We're going to show the highlights and the lowlights. Let's go.
We title these plays, folks, The Hands of Stone. Drew Zielinski is nonchalant here, and who pays Grant? Hall falls down, and Kasper slides at home. The old man wouldn't have been happy about this, Brent. And Kasper says, thank you. McAuliffe sends Curry in on a breakaway, and when you do this, you're minus one. routine icing here, and Chelios and Ludwig pull the old Alphonse and Gaston routine. You got it? No, I got it. No, you got it? No, but Umdi's got it. My buddy Chris Katsopoulos gives a perfect pass, and he's minus one. Sorry, Todd, I had to show this one. Gill gives the puck to Troy Murray, and the Blackhawks are in the playoffs. Murray happy or what? Sorry, Todd boy. There is nothing more embarrassing in sports than what you are about to see. Craig Ludwig got a hat trick in this game. Unfortunately, two were for Chicago. Back to the point. Dougie Wilson winds up. Off his knee in the net. Get out of the way, Craig. Al MacInnis tips one by Vernon, and Al's a little upset, as you can see. And Vernon says, what's going on here? Poor Pittsburgh Steve Dykstra gets his stick tapped by Captain Kirk Muller, and in it goes. I am sure Stevie Smith is tired of seeing this. Watch Stevie's pass bank off Fuhrer and in the net. I felt sorry for Stevie on this one. 12 seconds left, Vancouver up by one. Vancouver gets the draw, and Lars Lindgren puts it in his own net. Tough luck, Lars. This is the toughest one of all. Watch poor Gordy Denis. It comes to him in front. He's trying to clear it behind the net and beats Billy Smith. Boy, you feel terrible on that one. What a backhand. Sorry, Gordy. We're going to show it again. Slow motion. Billy, you should have had it. It was short side.
Boy, I'll tell you, you talk about a tough job coaching. I'll tell you, they get it in the neck. If 18 guys are lousy, who gets fired? The coach. You know, everybody's mad at them all the time. The general manager's mad at them. Everybody's mad at them. So you can't blame them when they get peeved during a game. I'll tell you, you know, the referees put them in their spot. I remember John McCauley one time. Stan Jonathan in Washington, he got a two-minute minor. He was fighting with Dennis Hextall. He got a two-minute minor. He got a five-minute major, 10-minute misconduct, and a game misconduct. Hextall got nothing. I said, yelled at McCauley. I said, hey, how come he gets all that? You get a game misconduct for winning a fight? He says, that's one penalty you never ever got, Cherry.
Folks, we're going to show you why coaches go gray. There's nothing worse than having a goal call back. Koharski says no goal, and Quebec players go nuts. Is he speaking French or English? Because Koharski can hardly understand English, let alone French. Here we have a goal not counting against the Habs. What's happening? Does it count or does it? Nobody knows. Still nobody knows. Ron Hogarth skating backward goes over. He's going to confer with his linesman, which should really confuse him. Jean Perron, what's happening? Who's playing here today? What's going on? Get away. That's what they say to you. Get away. I don't know if it counts or not, but by the way Keenan's acting, it's going against Philly, which it did. Now, would you believe another goal not counting against Montreal? And Jock says he's going to break Klima's neck if it doesn't count. What? Get him by that neck. With that helmet, I would too. Goal judge says no. Jock says yes. Turn the light on. Among other things. Now here's Terry Criss, who thinks Pittsburgh have too many men on the ice, and I don't want you people reading lips. He's either telling the referee too many men on the ice or wants to meet him for dinner at 6. He gets excited like this for Pittsburgh. Imagine what he gets like for Edmonton. Remember now, what I said, no reading lips. Brophy doesn't like this call. John's either got to go to the bathroom or he's doing the chicken dance. Now watch slamming this door. Way to go, John. Watch slamming this door now. I got my finger caught once, and it smarts. Rumor has it that Coach Bob Murdoch locked himself in the dressing room when things were going tough. But the GMs always have a way to make you come out. No use hiding on him. I'm just kidding. The door was really just stuck. But you know, he doesn't look too anxious to get out there though, does he? I don't blame him. Every once in a while, coaches even get mad at each other. Here's my buddy Shock Demers and Herbie Brooks having a little disagreement. Watch poor Tim Higgins getting a workover. Oh, try to hold Jock back. He's really mad. Look at him go. Whoa, hold me back. Herbie's just bugging Jock. Thinks he's just kidding. Hey, come on, Jacques. Jacques's not kidding, though. Jacques is not kidding. He's really ticked. Even I used to get upset a little. Great suit, eh? Medill threw me out, and Jerry Cheever's a backup goalie coached his first game. I'm often asked, what's the greatest goal you ever saw scored? Well, it was in the Boston Gardens. It was Bobby Orr. Who else? Now, Bobby, when he was killing a penalty, he'd go behind the net, come out in front, go behind the net, come out in front. He'd make monkeys of everybody. So the Flames were playing him, and they didn't want to run in, so, you know, and he'd go around behind the net. So what happens? He comes along the side. They don't want to run at him because, hey, you know what'll happen? He'll go and hide again. Down the side, he goes in the corner, comes out in front and scored. The greatest goal I ever saw scored, and you're going to see it. It's the first one coming up. Let's watch. Okay, folks, watch this one. Bobby's got the puck, and he's killing a penalty. He goes back behind the net and starts back up. Nobody wants to rush him, so he blows by two guys, goes around the defense, sucks the goalie into the corner, and sips her home. He puts his head down because he feels bad. He embarrassed the Flames. What a guy. Now, Dennis Savard can be the most exciting player in the game. Just watch some of these goals. Watch him weave a little magic against the Habs. Danny Gallivan calls this a spinorama. He loves to score. Now this one has to rank up there with one of the best. Around Anderson. Around Tikkanen. Gives Lowell the old how's she going and slides her past Grant. Folks, that deserves another look. Look at him go. Little waterfall. He looks fast in slow motion. A beauty. Now here's Troy Murray, one of my favorites. This has to be a great goal or brutal defense. Walks around Salming, turns Iafredi inside out, and tucks her home. Beauty. Al MacInnis has the hardest shot in hockey. Watch some of these blasters. Billy Smith still hasn't seen it. Lucky it didn't hit you, Billy. In Calgary, they have to reinforce the net for this guy. He can smoke them. Vancouver's Greg Adams gets a nice one here against Buffalo. Greg Dipsy doodles around Riki and slides it past Poopa. Here it is again in slow motion. Over, back, nice one to the left. Digs their home. Beauty. Now, what's great goals without one from the great one? Watch Wayne cruise around the net and pop it home. Not much Vernon could do with two guys sitting on him. Now, this has to be the greatest goal never scored. Even though he didn't score, we got to show this. Watch, around and around, back. He goes back again.
Around he cuts out. Put it up high, put it up high. I'm telling Gretzky how to score. And last but not least, Mario the Magnificent. Watch him split the two defensemen and pop it in the top corner. Let's see that one in its slow motion. This guy can score with two guys sitting on him. Long reach, that's how he can do it.
Before we go to my favorite part of the show, let's see a few funny things that happen in hockey.
Now, folks, this isn't really funny. Some jerk in L.A. threw a live chicken on the ice. Finally, after the play stops, the players see it's okay. They hate that stuff. Looks like a new Swedish draft pick. Or chicken a la King. Get it? Nobody calls L.A. chicken now with Miller and Baumgartner. This gives a new meaning to chicken in a bucket. There's Kenny Linsman on a breakaway. Here's Calgary's trainer, Bob Camp Murray, seeing if he's got any hair left. Watch Steve Finn. Who does he think he's playing for, the Blue Jays? 2 minutes for being stupid, Stevie. Now, there's one thing about my buddy Chris Nolan. He never gets upset about getting a penalty. He always takes it graciously. Now, here he's applauding the ref's call. No, he don't throw it down. He just wanted to give somebody else a drink. Now, don't read lips now. Isn't he a wonderful boy? Boston Gordy Kluzak's having a tough time putting the sweater on. And here's my buddy Chris Nylund saying, you put the right arm in first, Gordy. Check those knuckles, folks. That's not from playing at the end. And here's Jerry O'Reilly saying, Chris, let him figure out how to put his own sweater on. This is how they show them to their seats in the Boston Garden. And here's Kevin McClellan and Greg Smith having a little disagreement. One thing about hockey players, they're always gracious to one another. In fact, after the tussle, Kevin even offered Greg his own water bottle. And Greg says, no, thank you, you can have it back. Among other things. And the ref said, if you guys can't play nice, you can't play at all, and sent them home. Don't read lips.
And now here's Blue's favorite part of the show, the hits. You know, old-timers tell me Bill Gadsby threw the hardest hit of all time against Timmy Horton. It was in the Toronto Maple Leaf Gardens. Bill was playing for Detroit. They hit like freight trains. Unfortunately, it was at center ice, a clean check. Unfortunately, Timmy came away with a broken jaw and leg in the same hit. He was okay later on. The hardest one I ever saw was in the Boston Gardens. Larry Playfair, he was just a rookie. He was just up for one game. He stepped on the ice from the bench, went behind the net with the puck. Here comes John Winsink, hit him. It was stretcher time for Larry Playfair. Scott Steven is the hardest hitter in hockey today, and we're going to start with him. Let's go, Scott.
Okay, folks, let's just sit back and enjoy.
birthday beauty hits, folks. Thanks for watching. What's that, Blue? Oh, yeah, you're right. Hey, you folks, I know what you're thinking out there. What's a Don Cherry video without the odd tussle? You're right. But you people that don't like fights, you don't like violence, I'm going to give you time to turn it off. Is that enough time? All the sweethearts gone? They can't complain. Now, we're going to start with our strange one, Wayne Gretzky and L.A.'s Phil Sykes. Let's go.
Now, you won't believe this one. This is Gretzky's first fight and Curry's last, believe me. Poor Sykes is in there. Now, watch them go down. Fury says, I can't believe this. Curry's trying to help. Get your glove off. Nobody's going to hit you, Curry. Now, they get up here. They're all tangled up. I don't know what's going on here. Nobody knows. Gretzky's from behind. Curry wants to give him a kiss, I think. I don't know what's happening here. Gretzky says, leave me alone. It's embarrassing. The referee skates away. He can't stand it. There goes the glove. In Curry's face. Curry's saying, please stop it. Gretzky's back down to rescue him. Fuhrer's in there, too. Sykes says, I don't know what's going on. I'm getting embarrassed here, too. So it's ring around the Rosie. Back in the corner. Referee comes back again. Are you guys still going at it? Now, here's the two guys that aren't fooling. Cox and Probert. Folks, you're never going to see a better one than this one. We counted the punches. There was 71 and 50 seconds. Back and forth. Probert is something else, but Cox doesn't back down, I'll tell you. Nobody backs down on this one. This was the talk of hockey for a long time. Both standing up there, that Probert, I don't know. Too bad he's out of hockey now. Let's hope he makes it back. And Cox says, let's go, mister, I'm ready for you. Back and forth. I don't understand how their arms don't get tired. See how everybody stands back? Two tough guys going at it. They want to go, let them go. They're not hurting anybody but themselves. That's when they should jump in, which they did. Good job. Stickle and Finn, good job. Wolfman McElhaggy thinks it's great, too. Way to go, Craig, and way to go, Bobby. Here's two super heavyweights going at it. Miller, when he was with Boston. Kordick with Canadians. Two lefties here. Watch the lefties go. Got to get set up here, folks. Watch them go. Cordy can really throw that left. And now Miller comes back with the left. Like I say, two tough guys going. They're not hurting anybody but themselves. Why jump in? There's the helmets off. Looks like we've speeded up the action. Getting tired here. They get tired here, boy. This is tiring. The way it should be. Two tough guys. They stop. Now they try to grab each other's pants here. The first time I saw this was with Jonathan. Kordick grabs his, gets down on top of Miller. I think I'm going to call this one a draw. Good one. Gary O'Reilly likes it. The players like it. So do Canadians. Now, folks, I know the film's not too good on this, but we thought we'd show it anyhow. This is the greatest defensive battle of all time. Batillo and McSorley. Now watch this. I'm going to get them. No, they're kicking the gloves out of the way. They thought it was really going to be heavyweight. Koharski saying, go ahead, you guys. Go ahead. Now they're in there. They're out there. They're in there. Hope, faint. A little faint here and then faint back again. Now, no, wait. Linesman, get in there. Stop it. Two tough guys. I just made fun of them. Sorry, guys. It was a goodie.
And that's Don Cherry's Rock'em Sock'em Hockey. Thanks for watching.